let's talk about our system of dual designation. ORS means orthogonal rake system. Okay, this is a single point cutting tool. This is a CAD model. This is a rake face. This is the flank surface, principal flank surface. And this is the auxiliary flank surface of this tool. And this edge over here, this is called cutting edge. This fillet is called nose radius. Okay, in this system we have 5 planes instead of 3 like in AIS system, and 6 angles. This is a reference plane, and you can see this plane is parallel to this surface, and we have cutting plane. If you observe clearly, this plane contains the cutting edge, and this plane is also perpendicular to this reference plane, as you can see here. And there is a plane which is perpendicular to this cutting plane, which is this. This is called orthogonal plane. This orthogonal plane is perpendicular to cutting plane, and this orthogonal plane is also perpendicular to the reference plane. Look at this plane. If you observe clearly, as I said before, this is the auxiliary cutting edge, just like this cutting plane, which has this cutting edge. This auxiliary cutting plane has this auxiliary cutting edge passing through it, and also this auxiliary cutting plane is perpendicular to this reference plane. And similar to this orthogonal plane, there is auxiliary orthogonal plane, which is perpendicular to auxiliary cutting plane. Okay, these are 5 planes, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, right? Let's look at all the angles, right? I said 6 angles. The first angle we are going to take a look at is orthogonal rake angle. Let's look at the definition. It is the angle of orientation of tool's rake surface from the reference plane and measured on the orthogonal plane. Let's see what that means here. Okay, this is the orthogonal plane, right? If I cut the tool in such a way, and you can see this edge, the angle between this edge and the horizontal, this angle is called orthogonal rake angle. The second angle is inclination angle. Inclination angle is the angle of inclination of tool's principal cutting edge from the reference plane, which means that the inclination of this cutting edge from this reference plane. Orthogonal clearance angle. It is the angle of orientation of tool's principal flank surface from the cutting plane, and it is measured on the orthogonal plane. Let's see what that means. This is the cutting plane. This is the orthogonal plane. What that means is the angle between this principal flank surface and this cutting plane, this angle is called orthogonal clearance angle, and it is measured on this orthogonal plane. One easy way to interpret this is cutting the tool like so and observing it here. The angle between this edge and this plane, if you can see, this angle is called orthogonal clearance angle, auxiliary orthogonal clearance angle. It is the angle of orientation of tool's auxiliary flank surface from the auxiliary cutting plane and measured on auxiliary orthogonal plane. Let's see what that means. This is the auxiliary orthogonal plane. This is the auxiliary cutting plane. This surface of the tool is called auxiliary flank surface. If I cut this tool like this, the angle between this edge and this plane, this angle is called auxiliary orthogonal clearance angle. There are 2 more angles remaining, which are principal cutting edge angle and auxiliary cutting edge angle. Now, this is a cutting plane and this is the auxiliary cutting plane, right? Let me cut the tool like this. So, if I cut the tool like this and observe it from the top, this is like this. Assume the longitudinal feed direction is like this, which means that the tool moves from here to here while operating. The angle between the cutting plane and the longitudinal feed direction, this angle is called principal cutting edge angle. Similarly, the angle between auxiliary cutting plane and the azimuth longitudinal direction, this angle is called auxiliary cutting edge angle. Let's see the designation of each angle. So here we can see lambda is used to represent inclination angle, gamma o is used to represent orthogonal rake angle, alpha o is used to represent orthogonal clearance angle, alpha o dash is used to represent auxiliary orthogonal clearance angle, phi is used to represent principal cutting edge angle, and phi 1 is used to represent auxiliary cutting edge angle, and r is nose radius. And here we can see there is mm in the brackets, which means in our system you have to represent nose radius in mm only, but in AIC system we represent nose radius in inches.